Welcome back in lecture series on topic chemical thermodynamics, and today we will solve numerical based on work done in chemical reactions. So let us see how to solve the numerical problems based on work done in chemical reactions. So for that we require the formula W is equal to minus delta NG RT, where delta NG means change in number of moles of gases, product and reactant. So we can write this formula like this also. W is equal to minus N2 minus N1, that is delta NG, into RT. While solving the numerical problem, you have to remember that if W is given in joules, R must be in joules. And if W is given in kilojoules, R must be in kilojoules. Here R means gas constant, T means temperature, and delta N2 minus N1 means delta N, that is change in number of moles. Sometimes number of moles are not given directly, and in such a cases you have to find out the number of moles of the reaction, and therefore for that you must know the formula, that is N is equal to W divided by M. So you have to use this formula, and using this formula you can calculate number of moles from mass of substance and molar mass of substance. So, also sometimes the question is asked like this: state whether in a given chemical reaction work is done by the system or on the system. And to solve or to answer these questions, you must know the conditions under which delta N is negative, under which delta N is, if it is negative, then work, what is the sign of work, or if delta N is positive, then what is the sign of work, that you must know, that is conditions you must know. So suppose here the delta N is equal to 0, work done is equal to 0, and in such a cases no work is done by or on the system. If delta N is positive, that means N2, number of moles of product, gaseous product, are greater than number of moles of gaseous reactant, then work is done by the system, and W is negative. And the third condition, that is delta N is negative, that means N2, that is number of moles of gaseous product, are less than number of moles of gaseous reactant, then work is done on the system, and sign of work is, in such a cases, it is positive. So remember all these points. We will solve the numerical problem based on work done in chemical reaction from your exercise. That is, calculate the work done in the decomposition of 132 grams of ammonium nitrate at 100 degrees Celsius. NH4NO3, 1 mole of NH4NO3 in a solid state gives you N2O in a gaseous state plus twice H2O in a gaseous state. State whether the work is done on the system or by the system. Now what is given here in this example? Temperature is given, 100 degrees Celsius. You have to convert it into Kelvin, that is 373 Kelvin. Mass is given, that is 132 gram of ammonium nitrate, and that is here you have to calculate number of moles from this mass. And reaction is given for 1 mole. Decomposition reaction is for 1 mole of ammonium nitrate. So you have to find out, or you have to rewrite, you have to write the reaction for 132 gram, and for that first you have to calculate 1 mole of ammonium nitrate means how many grams, and from that you have to calculate what 132 grams corresponds to how many number of moles, and for that means you have to calculate number of moles, then delta N, then work done, and whether work is done on the system or by the system, that you have to determine in this problem. So N is equal to W divided by M, where W means mass of a substance, M means molar mass of substance. To calculate molar mass of a substance, you must know atomic masses involved, atomic masses of the elements involved in the formula of ammonium nitrate. So ammonium nitrate contains three elements: nitrogen, hydrogen, oxygen. Nitrogen has atomic mass 14, hydrogen has 1, and oxygen has 16. So using this you can easily calculate molar mass. Delta N you have to calculate, and W you have to calculate from this formula, that is minus N2 minus N1 into RT, that is W is equal to del minus delta NG RT. Using this formula we have to calculate work done. And R is known to you, that is 8.314 joules per Kelvin per mole. Now N is equal to W divided by M. Atomic masses are known to you, N is equal to 14, H is equal to 1 and O is oxygen is equal to 16. So molar mass of ammonium nitrate is, here 2 nitrogens are there, so 2 into 40, 4 hydrogens are there, so 1 into 4 and 3 oxygens are there, so 3 into 16, that is 28 plus 4 plus 48 and it is equal to 80 grams. So 1 mole of ammonium nitrate is equal to how much, how many grams? 80 grams. And molar mass of ammonium nitrate is given to you, and that is 132 grams. So now you know molar mass and mass of ammonium nitrate. So substitute these values in this formula, 132 grams divided by 80 grams, and that is equal to log to the base, we have to solve this by log to the base 10 of 132 grams as it is divided by 80 minus log to the base 10 of 80. So log of 132 is 2.1206 and log of 80 is 1.19031. So 2.1206 minus 1.9031 and that is equal to 0.2175, and antilog of this is how much? 1.650. So number of moles of ammonium nitrate is equal to 1.650, and we have to calculate work done by decomposition of 1.650 moles of ammonium nitrate. So here the reaction is given for 1 mole. So you have to write the reaction for 1.6 mole, or you can solve this example using this equation also, that is for 1 mole. First calculate what the work done for 1 mole and then calculate it for 1.65 moles. So here this is for, this reaction is for 1 mole, that means 1 mole when decomposes, it gives you 1 mole of N2O gas and 2 moles of water. Now when for 1.65 moles, you have to write the reaction like this also. You can write the reaction like this, that is for 1.65 moles of ammonium nitrate, when it decomposes, then it gives you same number, 1.65 moles of N2O gas and 2 moles of water, that means 1.65 into 2, that is equal to 3.30 moles of water. So total number of moles of reactant, as reactants are in a solid state, you have to take it as a 0. Total number of gaseous products are 1.65 plus 3.30 moles, that is 0 moles, and here number of moles of product is 4.9 moles. So delta N is equal to 4.95 moles. 4.95 moles is the number of moles of product, gaseous product, and the number of moles of gaseous reactants are 0. So delta N is equal to 4.95 moles. Now substitute this value in formula, W is equal to minus delta NRT. So W is equal to minus into bracket 4 point number of moles, delta N is equal to change in number of moles is equal to 4.95 moles, into R 8.314 joules per Kelvin per mole, and temperature 373 Kelvin. Now Kelvin is cancelled, mole is also cancelled, and therefore minus into bracket 4.95 into 8.314 into 373, and that is equal to minus log to the base 10 of 4.95 plus log to the base 10 of 8.314 plus log to the base 10 of 373. So we will see the log of 4.95 is 0.6946, log of 8.314 is 0.9198 and log of 373 is 2.5717. And by adding all this, we get what? 4.1861. And antilog of this is 1535. But here, characteristic is 4. So you have to write the decimal point after 5 digits. So 15350.0. So W is equal to minus 15350.0 joules. And in kilojoules divided by 1000, so W is equal to minus 15.35 kilojoules. Therefore, as sign is negative and delta N is positive, therefore work is done by the system. Expansion type of work is there. Now, see the second problem. Calculate the amount of work done in oxidation of 1 mole of HCl gas at 200 degrees Celsius according to the reaction. This reaction is for 4 moles. 4 moles of HCl gas plus 1 mole of oxygen gas gives you 2 moles of Cl2 gas plus twice H2O gas. And second reaction, that is decomposition of 1 mole of NO at 300 degrees Celsius for the reaction of for 2 moles, that is 2 moles of NO on decomposition gives you 1 mole of N2 gas plus 1 mole of O2 gas. Now what is given? Oxidation to this reaction, there are two parts in this problem. First, that is oxidation of 1 mole, you have to calculate work done for oxidation of 1 mole of HCl. And second, that is you have to calculate decomposition of 1 mole of the NO gas. Temperature is given, that is for first part, it is 473. Actually, it is given in 200 degrees Celsius. That is in degrees Celsius, you have to convert it into Kelvin, and that is equal to 473 Kelvin. Like that, temperature for decomposition is 300 degrees Celsius. That means in Kelvin it is 573 Kelvin. What you have to calculate? First you have to calculate delta N for both the reactions, and then you have to calculate work done for both the reaction. We will solve first oxidation of HCl. Now here the reaction is like this. 4 moles of HCl gives you, reacts with 1 mole of O2 and gives you 2 moles of Cl2 and 2 moles of the water. Now for 1 mole, the reaction becomes like this, divided by 4. So 4 by 4, 1. So 1 mole of HCl gas plus divided by 4, 1 by 4 moles of O2 gas gives you, divided by 4. So it becomes equal to half moles of Cl2 gas and half mole of H2O. So here 1 mole plus 1 by 4 mole means 0.25 moles, and here half moles means 0.5 and half mole means 0.5. So total moles of reactant 1.25 and total moles of product 1 mole. So delta N is equal to 1 mole minus 1.25 mole, that is equal to minus 0.25 mole. Delta N is negative, and you know that delta N is negative, work done is positive. So you can directly write the answer of that question, that is what is the work done, whether the work done by the system or on the system. Here as delta N is negative, work is done on the system. Now you can calculate W using this formula. Delta N is equal to RT, N is equal to minus 0.25 mole, R is equal to 8.314 joules per Kelvin per mole, T is equal to 200 degrees Celsius, that is equal to 473 Kelvin. Substituting these values in the formula, we get what? Minus into bracket, the number of moles are negative, so minus 0.25 mole into value of R 8.314 इंटू टेम्परेचर 473 केल्विन, केल्विन केल्विन कैंसल, मोल मोल कैंसल, सो हियर माइनस इंटू ब्रैकेट माइनस 0.25 इंटू 8.314 जूल्स इंटू 473 केल्विन. So log to the base 10 of 0.25 plus log to the base 10 of 8.314 plus log to the base 10 of 473 kelvin. So log of 0.25 is bar 3979, log of 8.314 is 9198, and log of 473 is 2.6749. adding all these we get what, 2.9926. Antilog of 0.9926 is 9831. Characteristic is 2. So you have to place decimal after 3 digits. So 983.1. So here this negative negative sign becomes positive. So W is equal to plus 983.1 joules, and that is equal to 0.9831 kilojoules. If you divide this quantity by 1000, you will get in kilojoules, work done in kilojoules. And as the sign is positive, work is done on the system, W is positive. Now the second part of this, that is, you have to calculate work done for 1 mole of decomposition of 1 mole of NO gas. Reaction is given for 2 mole. Now we have to write the reaction for 1 mole. So here for 1 mole, the reaction is like this. 1 mole of NO gas gives you half mole of N2 gas and half mole of O2 gas. So here total number of moles of reactant, 1 mole. And total number of product also 1 mole. Half mole means 0.5 mole. So 0.5 plus 0.5, that is equal to 1 mole. So delta N for this reaction is 0 mole. And substituting this value, 0 moles means no work done. So W is equal to 0 into 8.314 joules per kelvin per mole into 573 kelvin, that is equal to 0. And therefore no work is done by the system or on the system. So thank you.